news.
Hey, welcome back to our Stupid Rx of Corp.
I'm Rick.
You can follow us on Instagram, Twitter for more juicy content. Thank you to our supporters on Patreon. Follow us to the account, subscribe, like button.
Thank you, Patreon members, for being so patriotic.
Today we got a video. It just came out about 13 days ago, but it's jamming on Emraan Hashmi songs featuring Emraan Hashmi.
Okay.
Apparently, Emraan sings a whole bunch of his songs with a whole bunch of people. Choir of people. Okay. Is singing him his songs. But what would that be equivalent to here? Like, not John, like, because at first it would be John Williams, but you can't really sing to those because they're score.
Yeah, you could. Everybody knows the melodies.
But what, because obviously we don't have the same thing here of a...
The closest thing I'm thinking of would be when you go to the Hollywood Bowl and they do the Sound of Music sing-along or Grease.
Oh, and if, like, Julie Andrews.
Right.
Or, yeah.
And they've done that before where they do a staged reading, as it were, of a really classic show. Like, they'll do Hairspray, but they don't really do full choreography. They just have the people on mics mm-hmm. and the orchestra, and you can sing with them while they're doing their thing. That'd be the closest we have here.
Yeah. But Emraan is, especially love songs, as you know.
Yeah.
He was the big kind of almost sex icon. What was that? Did you hear that chord?
I did hear that chord.
It sounded what worship song is that?
It sounded like "The Closer I Am to Fine" by the Indigo Girls.
No,
but
it sounded like
we
every
stand
worship
and lift up our hands.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, for the joy of the Lord is our strength.
But isn't like every worship song the same three chords essentially,
in different keys? They're very simple chord structures most of the time. Yes,
I know that.
I know.
Yes, we stand and lift up our hands.
I bet there's stupid babies in this.
I bet there are.
It looks like a youth group.
It does. This looks like a Wednesday night service somewhere.
I wonder how many of these songs he actually knows the lyrics to.
they probably know them better than he does.
Rick's done many of these jam sessions before.
I have hundreds of them. One of my favorites was with the Hula tribe in Papua New Guinea. It was half this number in a house. I like they're harmonizing and everything. It's nice.
Yeah, he doesn't know.
Yeah, he's reading it.
He doesn't sing these on his off time.
No.
Become part of the culture, like even sometimes more, way more than the film ever was.
Ooh, I like the shoes.
connected to this one before. It sounds familiar.
Singing along.
All of them. That guy looks like
some of them do not even need. Oh, no, they don't need to look at paper. No, notice the guitar players don't need to be looking at the chords either. They're just playing. They know the songs.
We just reacted to that.
Naho. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We thought it was Kaho Naho when we saw the title.
Hey, what are you doing back there? I'll take a bathroom break in the middle of the song.
He's not even singing it. It's like, you guys do that. One of those boxes, they're fun.
I never played one of those either.
Well, it's a little more accessible to do those boxes than it is to try to just pick up a guitar and play it.
I just realized right now what fucking awesome songs I've got. Thank you guys, thank you, that was fantastic.
Hi, Emraan.
We stand and lift up our hands.
Yeah, that's what it was. In the key that Chris Tomlin sings it in. Yeah, that first chord.
We stand and lift up our hands.
That's exactly
what
it is.
For the joy of the Lord is our strength. Holy is the Lord.
That's the key that Chris Tomlin sings it in.
And it's the same exact chord.
It's the same same chords.
I just got taken back. Youth group in middle school.
Yep.
This is so interesting because it's such an Indian thing. A lot of times the songs become way bigger than that film.
Oh, yeah.
Ever is.
It
could be a completely shit film that flops.
Right.
But the songs are now part of the culture.
Forever.
Of India. And I know he has a bunch of those. But it's also funny because he probably learned the lines to the song just like any other lines in a movie.
Yep.
He brushes them. He doesn't listen to his own song.
If he's going to do a live concert of some kind, he refreshes.
Mm-hmm.
But then doesn't go back. Mm-mm. Same thing happens with actors when people start quoting lines from their films. And it's a cult classic, and they haven't looked at that film in 30 years, but other people have watched it multiple times a year for the past 30 years. So the fans know the movie better than the actor.
Yeah. I'm sure people like Shah Rukh Khan or Big B, like they get shouted certain things so many times, or they've re-performed their thing so many times.
Or their hook steps.
They know the hook steps Shah Rukh Khan, because they've done it so much in shows. But if it's just like something they did 20 years ago, there's no way they were.
No.
I was trying to remember the Hindi lines of the header. And I'm like, oh, I completely forgot how it entirely even starts.
Oh, forget about it. The show I just did in the spring, I bet if I was having to do a couple of those scenes again, it would be tough for me to, because once I'm done with it, my brain lets it go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You don't need to grab onto it anymore. So I'm sure it's the exact same
But oddly, there's other things that I memorized, like the 2013-year-old man when I was 10 years old. That never left my brain.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I guess because I just did this the other day. I hadn't done the scene in forever, but I just started quoting the interrogation scene by the Joker.
Mm.
And I when that first came out, I'd seen that movie 10 times in theaters, most I've ever seen a movie in theaters ever. And I'd memorized that scene. I've performed that scene for people.
Right.
But then I hadn't done it in years.
Right.
And I was just quoting it the other day, and I knew every single line down to the
pause. That just happened with me. It's interesting. I was doing an audition for something a few months ago that was for Hamlet, and I was debating on if I should do something of Claudius or I should do the ghost, because I played both characters, and I couldn't remember any of the lines of Claudius off the top of my head. But the monologue of the ghost, of Hamlet's father, every word of it was right back. Mm-hmm. I just started to say, I am thy father's spirit, and the whole two-minute monologue came out word for word.
Nice.
Hadn't done it in 10 years.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I bet it's the exact same way for these stars, especially like he has so many romantic songs that he doesn't listen to on his off time.
Paul McCartney did that in concert one time, and everybody laughed. He forgot the words to one of his classic Beatles song in the middle of singing of it. And then, of course, the audience remember it, and they all laugh together. Yeah. Even Paul McCartney forgets his lyrics sometimes.
Yeah. They're not as special to the artists, usually, as they are to the people listening to them.
No.
They're doing it because they like to perform.
Yeah. People. You'll listen to the song you wrote over and over again while you're making it.
Yeah.
But then it's gone.
Until you perform it again.
Yeah.
I think I saw Lil Wayne say, he's like, I don't know. I don't write anything down.
Mm.
Ever. Yeah. So like all of his songs are just off the top of his head. Which is
same with Michael.
Insanely impressive.
Yeah. Michael Jackson did that. He didn't write anything down. He just recorded it. And because he didn't write music and he also didn't play any instruments, everything was audio recordings. And he'd show that to Quincy Jones, and he knew exactly what he wanted the parts to do. So he would do that, and then Quincy could write it out.
Yeah, insane. Yeah. Anyways, cool. Let us know. I need to get to another Emraan Hashmi movie. What's your next Emraan Hashmi movie? And other, of course, songs that we can write to of his. Please let us know down below. Juice!